Good morning, everyone. My name is Scott Gunson, as the chairman of the Veterans Council here in Martin County. It's my privilege to welcome you to this year's Memorial Day Parade and Remembrance Ceremony as we honor and remember our countless heroes. As we begin our ceremony, we ask that you please rise for the posting of the colors, the singing of our national anthem by the Treasure Coast Community Singers Youth Chorus, led by Doug Jewett, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance and Invocation by Sheriff Snyder. I'll start us off on the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Can we please have a moment of silence for all of our fallen? Thank you. Can we now have Sheriff Snyder provide our invocation?
I was thinking this morning how fast culture changes and how what's normal and traditional one day seems to be outlier behavior just almost the very next day. And I think all of us have seen this latest trend. Keep your prayers to yourself. If you read social media or you look up, there's a lot of that genre of thought. We don't need prayer. We don't need your thoughts. We need your actions. And I say this morning, not in defiance, not to start a fight, but I don't believe that at all. And I do believe that prayer matters. And that we as free Americans stand here today keenly aware that our blood of our country spilled so that we can still pray in public. And so for those who say, I don't want your prayers, I don't want you thinking about me, too bad, because today, we're going to exercise one of our God-given and constitutionally empowered rights, and that is the right to pray. And as I do so, I stand here and want to openly thank God that my two sons, United States Marines, who served overseas in combat situations, are alive and well today. But some of you, God bless you, your Gold Star families, you live this every day. And so as I offer a word of prayer this morning, you are in my heart and in my prayers and in my thoughts. And thank you on behalf of the Martin County Sheriff's Office. And I know an exceedingly grateful nation. Thank you for your collective sacrifice. Father, as we begin this Memorial Day ceremony today, we're keenly aware that throughout the United States, all over, there are men and women, spouses, widowers, widows, aunts, uncles, cousins, children, who will be reflecting today on their loss, that their loved one is not with them. And Lord, for the many Marines, sailors, airmen, soldiers, Coast Guardsmen, all of those that have served in the United States Armed Forces and died on foreign battlefields, we pray for their families today, Lord. We ask that you would bless them and keep them. Lord, help them not to be bitter, which could be an easy thing to do. Help them, Lord, rather, to know that their loved one contributed to this very moment, that we stand here openly in prayer, not fearful of government. Lord, thank you for these families. Keep them, I pray. And Lord, we have different faiths here today. You are the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Lord, your eyes are upon this land. And we all pray differently or not pray if that's our choice. But Lord, I particularly pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Once again, I'd like to welcome everyone and thank you for coming. I'll be your MC for today's ceremony. Kind of new at this, so we'll do the best we can. I'd like to take a second to recognize and welcome all of our distinguished community leaders and guests that are here with us today. So hello everyone and thank you for being here. My first duty of the day is to recognize our Grand Marshal, Mr. Leon Pipes Avaz. He, along with his fellow driver, Veteran Brian Mast, led the parade down Ocean Avenue this morning. Pipes was a United States Army Sergeant and Korean War veteran who served our country from 1954 to 1959. And at one point in his military career, he was the middleweight boxing champion of the European Theater. He has quite a story to tell, so please be sure to read more about Leon in your program. Thank you, Mr. Grand Marshal. Stand up and give him the wave if you can. All right, give him the wave. Now I have the privilege to introduce to you our guest speaker, Mr. Bob Schertz. I want to give you a brief idea of his military service. And by the way, you can read far more about Bob in your ceremony program as well. Robert Schertz was born in Ohio. In 1969, he enlisted in the United States Air Force, where he served until 1975. He was on active duty. He served at Strategic Air Command Headquarters in Nebraska. He was also stationed in Okinawa, Japan, South Korea, and Thailand. When Bob received his top secret security clearance, he was assigned to the highly classified Eye in the Sky satellite program. Sergeant Schertz worked on satellite imaging, exacting photos and surveillance footage from the U-2 and SR-71 spy planes. He developed this media to make imagery maps and prints that could be focused within 1/10 of an inch. These highly classified films and imagery were used at the highest levels of the State Department and Department of Defense for decision-making during the Cold War era. This same station of assignment was responsible for surveilling Cuba and the actions of the Soviet Union during the Cuban Missile Crisis. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bob Schertz.
It is indeed an honor to be here to speak in front of you this day. You might be wondering about the uniform. I wear this in remembrance of a friend of mine. He was known as Major General Abram Ersic. He's also known as the commander who brought the first tank in the relief of Bastogne into Bastogne. So in his memory, I'm wearing the 4th Armored patch on my shoulder. He was a major at the time, so in case you were wondering, I was just a staff sergeant when I was. Anyway, today's a day of remembrance. Originally, Memorial Day was a day of remembrance and Decoration Day. People after the Civil War would go about decorating the graves of their loved ones that they lost during the Civil War, a great tragedy to this country. But basically, today's a day of remembrance, reflection, and honor to those who lost their lives in service to this country. After World War I, families continued this tradition with the introduction of the poppy. And there's a famous poem, "In Flanders Fields Where Poppies Grow." So you may see a few poppies out here today. And the funny thing is, the poppy was the first flower to bloom on the desolate fields of World War I. So that was adopted. Following World War II, Korea, and Vietnam, the U.S. government wanted to recognize all soldiers from all wars, and a National Memorial Day of tribute and honor was created. In 1971, last Monday in May became the official national holiday. And at 3 o'clock, a moment of silence is observed throughout this nation. A lot of people don't know this, in tribute to those who gave their lives the last full measure to this country. I'd like to honor some local soldiers who served and died for this great nation. Here's just a few of those honored today who gave the last full measure of devotion for this country. They were citizens of Stewart and Martin County. Private Harold R. Johns in France, September 30th, 1918. Corporal Larry Brown, Vietnam, February 5th, 1968. The first soldier from Stewart to die in World War II, Seaman Second Class Jack Matthews, February 22nd, 1942. Navy SEAL Special Ops Chief Aaron Carson Vaughn, Afghanistan, August 6, 2011. Marine Private First Class Charles F. Tyson III, Vietnam, June 21, 1969. Army Sergeant Thaddeus Dennis, Vietnam, April 11, 1971. In closing, during these difficult times, we should take a moment to reflect on our current military survivors who are in pain. They made it home, but a part of their life has passed away. To those of you suffering, you are not forgotten. You are our brothers and sisters, and while your wounds may not be visible, they will take time to heal, and we're here to help you at any time you need our help. Remember the POWs, and remember the missing actions of all those people that never made it home. I'd like to thank you, and for today, remember, reflect, and honor.
Thank you, Bob. I want to take a quick moment and thank the Stewart PD Honor Guard, the VFW 10132 Honor Guard, and the Martin County Television for the audiovisual services that they provide during these ceremonies. Also, we can't forget the tremendous job done every parade by Stewart Parades. The participants, and of course you guys, the crowd. Without you, it's just not the same anyway. A special thank you to Jim Reardon for organizing the parade. And finally, we thank the Martin County Veterans Service Office, the Martin County Board of County Commissioners, and the City of Stewart for helping make this event such a success. At this time, we will now have our wreath laying and necrology report.
Lou Jones, President of Vietnam Veterans Chapter of Martin County. We're not really good at communications, but as far as we know right now, we're all present and accounted for.
132.
VFW 10132, all present and accounted for.
I have the honor of presenting brothers and sisters who gave their best to veterans and will be greatly missed. Jean Eddy, Shirley Hogan, Brett Taylor, Rose Nowicki, Barbara Hinkle, Trish Harris, past chaplain Janet Blake.
American Legion Post 126. Former Officer Art Joy, Merle Rushton, Steve McGuffey, Tom Wyant, Larry Cook, Eugene Rathgerber, Gerard Hedgers, Richard Gear, Joseph Maneski, James McIntyre, Gerald Mulvaney, Nelson Stevens, and our longtime finance officer, Joe Loria.
Ambit Post 92, all present and accounted for.
Ladies Auxiliary, Post 92, lost two members, Bonnie Thompson and Kathy Hammond.
Lance Corporal Justin J. Wilson, Detachment 1045. One of our members, Vietnam Combat Veteran John Reedy, received his new orders to guard the streets of heaven.
Stuart Jensen, Elks Lodge, number 1870. Our departed members, Kenneth Mathia, Michael Salerno, Leonard Margiotta, Thomas J. Monty, Mr. Gary L. Worthy, Terry E. Troop, John S. McLaughlin, Judith Messina, Robert Bozak, Arnold Wayne Sloat, John Weiskop, Larry Needham, Vera C. Jenkins, Ms. Barbara A. Frestieri, Robert H. Knapp, Walter Payne, Louise Forgione, William Clewan.
Patioke Chapter, National Daughters of the American Revolution. Colleen Kimball, Roberta Hoffman, Geraldine Smith, Maggie Herchawa, Martha Miller Levely, Jean Jardin, Montel Truitt, Sally Stamen, Linda Cassio, Bonnie Buchan, Ruth Hardin.
Father McGivney, 4th Degree Assembly, number 1764, Knights of Columbus, Stuart, Florida. The faithful departed, Kenneth Sunshine, Miles B. Fisk, Edward Gauguin, Joseph DeContis, Antonio V. Verrecchio, John F. Frost, William B. Hughes, Sr., John William Sabo, Terry J. Hurt. May they rest in peace, and may God bless America.
May they all rest in peace.
We ask that everyone please rise for a rifle salute and the playing of taps in honor of all fallen heroes.
Thank you. You may now be seated. As a point of information, the city of Stuart will be unveiling this year's Distinguished Service Award winner. So please welcome Alice Lockhart, who will speak about this year's honoree.
Hello, everybody. For the last number of years, we've tried to remember a local veteran. A local veteran who grew up, raised here in Martin County, went on to serve in the military, and was unfortunately never able to return. A lot of the names that we were mentioned today are some of those people. We're going to honor a special one today. And his name is Sergeant Thaddeus Dennis. This honor goes to a Vietnam veteran. Thaddeus Dennis was born August 26, 1948 in Stuart. His family lived at 727 East Church Street in East Stuart. His father was in the military also, was a Sergeant Daniel Dennis. He had a brother and he had a sister. They all attended East Stuart Elementary School in the 1950s. The family then had to transfer to Washington, D.C., where the father had been, you know, reactivated, and then later to Germany. So this is where Thaddeus also grew up, in Washington and in Germany. When the family does return to the States, they settle back in Washington, D.C. Thaddeus then eventually graduates from Coolidge High School in Washington, D.C. But his idea was to join the U.S. Army when he finished high school, which he did July 7, 1970. After some military training here, he was sent to South Vietnam. He was a specialist for, and he served with the U.S. Army 720th Military Police Battalion, Company B, as a policeman. On Sunday, April 11, 1971, Specialist Thaddeus Dennis, age 22, volunteered during his off-duty time to assist the midnight shift in transporting a relief guard from the Army Air Force Security Unit. And they, the people he was transferring were undergoing on-the-job MP training, which he was skilled in. And they were taking a guard and also to pick up a wounded POW to a surgical hospital. They were traveling in a Jeep. While en route to that hospital on highway LTL-27 near midnight, the Jeep ran off the road and overturned. Sergeant Dennis died from his injuries before he could be transferred to the hospital. The relief guard who was driving was injured also, but he eventually recovered. Thaddeus was unmarried and had no children yet. Thaddeus Dennis was buried at Arlington National Cemetery at grave in section, and his name appears on the Vietnam War panel 04W row 118, of which we are recognizing that Vietnam War Memorial in Washington, D.C., that this is the 40th year since that was established. His mother eventually moves back to Stuart and spent many years here. His brother and his sister stayed up in the Maryland area. His brother passed away in 2008, his sister in 2009, and the mother recently a few years ago. There are still several nephews and nieces of Thaddeus who live in Maryland, but they were unable to attend here in Stuart today. So, on representing the Dennis family and residents of Martin County, Sergeant Dennis's name will be added to our special plaque down by the American flag as our token of remembering our fallen local military people. So later on at the end, we will unveil the plaque and you can see the other names that we've done. So it's a wonderful honor that Stuart has done to remember these local people. Thank you.
Which now brings us to the benediction. Mr. John Snyder, will you please close today's program with your benediction? We do ask that you please remain standing for the playing of Amazing Grace immediately following our benediction.
Thank you. Please join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come together and remember the many heroes that paid the ultimate sacrifice so we can be here today. It says in your word that no greater love hath a man than to lay down his life for a friend. And today we remember the many that did this on our behalf. We ask that as we leave here today, we don't just leave and forget the ceremony that we experienced today, but we use this, Lord, as a challenge to leave here and live a life that is worthy of the sacrifice of the men and women who made again this day possible. We pray a special blessing on the Gold Star families that we know that are here and those around the country today. And let us join with them in this day of remembrance so that those who have paid the ultimate sacrifice are never forgotten. We pray these in your name. Amen.
Gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. I want to thank you once again for coming today and assisting us in honoring and remembering our fallen heroes all together. God bless you all, and God bless our heroes. Thank you.